Broadcasting all over the world at urbanbroadcastmedia.com. Delivering love and inspiration
24/7.
This is UBM Praise. The following show is paid programming and does not necessarily express the views and opinions of Urban Broadcast Media and its subsidiaries.
Thank you for listening to UBM Praise.
A young man that you all know is Joe the Policeman from the What's Going Down episode of That's My Mama. I want you to put your hands together and welcome him to the stage. Big round of applause.
Let's go.
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
What's his name?
Sir Walter Jones.
Whose show is this?
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
Say it again.
Sir Walter Jones.
Who are you with?
Sir Walter Jones.
One more game.
Sir Walter Jones.
The Sir Walter Jones Show, co-host Alvin Carter. We are a Christian talk show in where we tackle all the hot topics in a believer's walk.
Yes!
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
What's his name?
Sir Walter Jones.
Whose show is this?
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
Tonight,
say it again.
I just want to talk to the ladies.
Say
oh, fellas, you're cool, but... girls, if you got a good man, you'd better keep him.
That's right.
Oh, I know you're saying right now, what does she know? Who is she to tell me about my situation? Well, I don't know your situation, but whatever it is, you should try to stay together.
Yes!
You know that big argument that you had the other night, remember?
Oh, no.
Well, today it's not nothing. Just don't let them leave you, honey. Because then you'll find out that it wasn't those real big things you loved about him.
Oh.
It was the real small things. Go on and laugh, but it's true. You know, things that you've seen 1,000 times around the house but never paid any attention to. Like helping with the groceries and helping in the yard. And painting and repairing and paying the bills. But you know now, all I have is memories and regrets. I could have given our love a chance to grow, but no. I had to challenge it and be heard. Let me tell you something. That female liberation stuff. I don't know, sometimes I don't think it's worth it. And I'm really feeling... feeling kind of bad, y'all.
Aww.
I'm catching hell.
Ladies, what do you want to know? How bad do you want to know it? What are you willing to do to find out? Tune in to the men's group right here at the Sir Walter Jones Show at UBM Praise.
Hello, everybody. Sir Walter Jones of the Sir Walter Jones Show. I am he, and she's catching hell. Not sure why she's catching hell, because apparently something's going on in her house with her man, with her. Well, she kind of let us know what that was. She gave us a little intro and talked about some things that were going on. And she was talking to the ladies. She was talking to herself. And, well, that's Natalie Cole, by the way. I'm Catching Hell, written by Chuck Jackson, that is. And believe it or not, this song was also written by the great Marvin Yancey. Y'all say, who's Marvin Yancey? I don't know who that is. If you lived in Chicago and if you at least 40 years old, you should know who Marvin... matter of fact, I got a file from Marvin in there called Heavy Load. Let's see. Dion, can you find that? Yeah, Heavy Load. Get him a quick sample of Heavy Load, because some people say, I don't know who Marvin Yancey is. Well, yeah, find Heavy Load. Heavy Load came out in 1985, I think it was. And it should be in my folder there. Lisa.
Give me a second, I'm fine.
Yeah, you find it. I believe it's in my folder. I think I put it on there. If I didn't, I think I was catching hell while I was preparing this show. Yeah, and I need you guys to, we're gonna have a very interesting show today. I don't know what it's gonna be. By 6 o'clock, we're gonna find out. Yeah, put that over either here or on this side. I got somebody coming in here. Yeah, either here or on that side right there. It's up to you. Art is here. I got Andre Daniels. He's here.
Yes, sir.
Oh, man. It's on, y'all. Alvin's coming. We've got Amanda's coming. Whew. I'm here. Oh, yeah. Turn that up.
Well, I got one ear going on here.
You've had all you can take, but I come to tell you, help is on the way. So just hold on, because you can make it through the night. Trust in the Lord, make it all right.
Yeah, y'all heard him now. Yeah, that's Heavy Load, Brother Anthony. Now, he was the pastor of the Fountain of Life Baptist Church over there on 43rd in Cottage Grove. And he married Natalie Cole. Yeah, and they were married for about 3 years, I think it was, had a child. And then they divorced, but he kept producing her projects. And then he remarried. Matter of fact, I was with the second wife just a couple of weeks ago, Sandra. Died young, though, man. 34 years old.
Oh, wow. Oh, that's a baby.
Yeah, wow. Yeah. Had a heart attack, I believe it was.
Oh, man, that's tragic.
That is tragic. But, yeah, so Natalie Cole says she's catching hell because apparently there was something going on between her and her man. All right, it's just so ironic that her ex-husband was the one who wrote this.
Maybe he was trying to tell something.
There's some signs and wonders.
Yes.
There's message. There's some ironic.
Maybe you're trying to say something. No, this is all.
Yes.
Yes. All right, what you going to do when Alvin get here? He gonna sit on you. You know that, right?
No, he's not.
He ain't
gonna. I move too fast.
Facebook has chimed in on this topic. Today's topic is things women do to annoy men. Mm-hmm. Oh. Yeah, things. Yeah,
right. That's the same question over.
Things women do to annoy men. All right. Now I'm gonna circle the room today. We're going there. We got the bodyguards out there hanging out at the door.
We don't need it.
We gonna need it. We had a pickup truck that pulled up next to the door. Y'all saw the pickup truck when you got here, right? Uh-huh. That's the bodyguards. They ready for us. The things that annoy us. Now, men, let me ask you a question, guys. You think men are easier annoyed than women?
No, it depends. No, this is one of those cases. It depends on what it is.
Okay.
Because we each have our key things that sets us off.
All right.
And to the other one, it's like, seriously, all I said or all I did. And sure. that goes back and forth.
I'm trying to see on a wide scale. Like if I had to choose one or the other,
yeah.
I think there's more stuff that irritate women about us than what we get irritated about. It's select things, but I know those things they set us off though. Like
just certain things that they do set us off. Gotcha.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's not.
And it seems like anything we do set them off.
Exactly. It seems like there's more of a landmine for us, you know.
He's a landmine. It's like, boom.
Yeah, so
what'd that do? You're breathing.
That one, I need that. Yeah, well, I'm breathing. How many times you gonna ask me about my weekend? That's what. No, that's interesting though. But you're right. Now I know on here on Facebook, Sherinda Robinson was saying, "Don't be generalizing." the sexes, pretty much.
When you get enough of a number where you can start seeing a similar type thing going around, not just in a set area, but when I can go ahead and talk to my homie in Indianapolis, my friend in Atlanta, another veteran brother out in California, and he has the same complaints and the same observations I have about, you know, the opposite sex where he is, then that gives me foundation for generalization.
Okay, I agree with that.
It's just a common thread that happens to be. It doesn't say that it's everybody, because there's always exception to the rules, but there are enough to where people have noticed and taken note and said, hey, I've seen the same thing.
I hear you. Amanda just sat down with that face. She looked at you like, really? Did you really say that? I can't believe you said that. Okay, wait. We got to get you on. We got to get you on. There you go. All right. Yeah.
I don't know if I heard him say him and one of the friends, they were talking, and those two friends came up with a generalization.
No. Yeah. Well, I said, what you heard, it wasn't two friends. It was several friends from several different locations in the United of these states.
So you and several of your friends.
Yep.
Even though we all know birds of a feather do flock together.
Not necessarily.
You and all of your friends.
I would like to apologize.
Not necessarily.
And made a statement.
I have to make a precursor here. Okay. I would like to apologize early for the presence of Amanda Hunt
/
Pettaway, because of it's about to go down.
This is juicy. It is juicy.
I like juice.
We got a room full of
love
me
some hey juice.
Here.
Y'all hear me? Juicy.
Well,
this is
Men's Chronicle.
Hey juicy. Hey,
tomorrow is about the pink. Today it's about men.
The blue. Hey, Amanda.
Yes, sir.
Well, I asked them a question. Do you think women, I don't know how fair this answer is going to be from you, but do you think
totally
women
unbiased,
are more,
man, totally
are,
unbiased.
Are more annoyed, are quickly, are quick, annoyed quicker than men?
Do I think they're quicker?
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely. Women, but it does, women? But they have their, yeah, absolutely, without a shadow of a doubt, we're quicker.
Yeah.
But it doesn't mean that we're deficient in areas that you guys are better in. So if you're saying quicker mentally, or if you're saying quicker in, like, for instance, men,
talking to Mike.
Oh, yeah, for instance, when it comes to men, I feel that men are quick when it comes to actually getting certain things done because they focus much better than us. We multitask better. So if you're saying, babe, can you take care of the groceries? Make sure you the cleaners are picked up. We're going to do that faster than you guys. But if we say, honey, can you get to, say it's a big project, you guys can focus on it and you'll actually get it done faster than us because you won't be thinking about a lot of different things.
I see.
So if there are small details, and when I say small, it's not small in significance, it's just small in the amount of speed it has to get done, then you guys, we do that faster. But if it's a larger project, sometimes in a lot of ways, because men can weed out a lot of the gray and the confusion and the, I gotta do this and that, you guys can get that done much faster. That's because you focus a lot better on one thing at a time.
You think who's more detailed in their tasks?
Oh, definitely women.
Women are more detailed in their tasks.
We're detailed in everything. I mean, you guys can't process past like 5,000 words, which is understandable because it's a lot. So we're telling you about the shirt, the details of the shirt, where it was made, what's the pattern, what's the when the designer was started. And you're like, no, the black one.
That's true. You think we're more detailed in what's passionate for us, though? That thing like sports or...
I think if you feel safe, you guys can be a lot more detailed. So if you feel safe. It's a place where you feel you're not going to be judged, you feel like you're not going to be belittled, or you feel like, hey, if I talk to you about this, even if you think it's silly, I'm passionate about it. Yeah, you'll run on for a long time about something that we may not understand, but you love it.
And you agree with that, Art?
If we give you a good space to do it, then you would.
Yeah, but... there's a slight alteration to you. What she described is the general man. That's a generalization.
Very true.
General man. Yeah. The birds of a feather flocking together.
Mm-hmm. Well, he
being
back.
No,
he had
no.
To back.
Yeah, I had to come back to that. But because in that particular thing, most of these guys that I was referred to are either A, artists.
Now let me tell you.
No, they are artists, or they are military.
Okay, so artists or military?
Military.
Okay.
To which there's a certain level of training that has to go into that to where you have to multitask as well as deal with the, you have to deal with the big picture,
very true,
as well as the very fine detail, because your life may depend on it.
Very true.
Now, as artistic individuals go, yeah, we will listen to about the fabric, the creation of this, that, and other, because we get a Jones for creativity, and that which is creation.
Yeah, they'll get a me for that.
Right, so,
right, you missed your cue, boom.
He missed it. He's focused.
But
he's
we're going through that. But
he's a man. He's focused.
On a whole, yes, I agree with her on this, because that is one of the reasons hanging with the cronies when I was coming up younger. It was like, you guys are boring because you always talk about the same thing over and over again. I don't want to say that. Yeah, you find me over there. Cackling with the ladies and
not
stuff.
Cackling.
Because
yes, he did.
Yes, cackling with them. Because they was like, they would say anything. They would say anything about anything and go a variety of
whole
subjects.
Directions.
Right. So I was like, that was cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I think we're very detailed in some things that we come very compassionate about. Mm-hmm. I'm detailed in my writing.
She was about like 5'6". She was about like curved, like yay, ham down to here. Yeah. It was down to here on this side, up to there on that side, and then at that profile, and then it was like a 360.
No, but that's,
on the father
that's
thing,
true.
Like, huh,
yeah, yeah. See, that's
true. That's true. See, we go in
prime
on that.
Prime example of what we're passionate about.
Man. Yeah, especially if we're lustful men, we're gonna remember all kinds.
Why be lustful? Why can't it be just the appreciation for the creation that God has put before
you,
us?
I'm with you on that. Everything is not completely lustful. Sometimes it's
just an appreciation of the artistry that God has put before us.
I only use one side. I said when we're lustful. I didn't say it in everything. Okay. When we're lustful, we remember. Or when we're madly in love with a woman, we remember as well. For instance, if we've been in love with a woman.
Three hairs coming out of one follicle.
Yeah, but that's true. We remember what she had on. We remember the music that was playing in the background. We remember all those things. Okay.
And the way you describe it usually details that when he was going through a description, you very rarely hear how intelligent she was.
Yep.
Or how kind she was, or her spirit. You're usually hearing
that's good
3,
stuff.
6 bus, because that's what you were drawn to.
You know that's what we're drawn to. That's good stuff.
It's true.
Men ain't gonna go too much in depth about, you know, the psyche and everything else of their woman, because that keeps the wolves away.
I can attest to that, because
delirious.
Yeah, because like I think when it comes to the physical, you can find that anywhere. But then when you start getting into the spiritual aspect of it and their actual being, then it's like, oh, that's a different level.
That's none of my boy's business.
Yeah,
see, because then
that's very backwards.
No, well,
I mean, if you would promote to me as a female, something like that, if you would promote the only physicality and with which much robustness.
Mm-hmm.
As you just laid out for us, oh, the lid and the gnat and the curtain, and then you would hide or you would cover the inner, more valuable, beautiful side of this woman. It's very to me backwards for a woman. When we talk about he has integrity, grand man, when he said he was going to do it, he showed up. We like yes.
Yeah.
Everyone on the outside walking down the street will say he's fine.
But you see,
very
we,
few of
as
us,
my boy,
talk, I'm sorry,
I don't want to have to bury my boy.
yes, you better.
But
told
very
you.
Few of us who as
I could have swore
women,
I was talking
or,
when she cut in anyway.
Yeah,
but
well, she's a woman though. Come
you
on,
were, no, you were not.
See,
you
that's what annoys you. Are you annoyed?
Run it back.
Are you annoyed?
You can run it back.
You
should do it.
Run it back.
Because one thing we can do is we can actually remember what's happening in the conversation.
Yes.
We're very good at detailing what happens. We should run it back.
So can I.
But what I do think is interesting is that there is a position that men normally take, which is understandable because they're created this way, to be visual. You're more visual than women.
Yeah, I understand, but that seems backwards to you, because I'm talking about a man talking to other men. So when you're doing your thing with your girls, then that's backwards for us.
No,
because we know how our brothers are.
Right.
So that's all we're going to keep it is on the physicality. But once you start breaking down to the innermost part of it, that means I might have to bury somebody.
Again, just because it's what you do doesn't make it healthy. I said
right.
backwards.
No, it's not backwards.
What a
that's
lot
just...
of women do is not healthy. The way we promote what we like in men is not healthy.
Right.
And there are a lot of what men do when they have conversations together. It is not healthy.
Right.
And for there to be a a very clear, open over sexualization of women. Not that we shouldn't be attractive. We shouldn't be beautiful. I think that's important. But
say
for that to be what is most dominant in the initial attraction between a man with his boys, but I can't discuss these other parts because they won't get it.
No,
you should
no,
be the
no.
changing
you're not getting it
around that group of men. You should be like, hey,
no,
look, dude, she's gorgeous.
Not,
I gotta tell you something about her. I feel like I'm myself, or I love how she whatever brings the best in
no,
me. And
see.
A lot of us women, we do the same thing. We say, girl, his money right, and you should see, girl, how he dressed.
That's
shallow,
she's
but it's
making
not
a great point.
She's making a great point for women. Right. We're talking about men. Okay. Because when we start building that,
yeah,
that inner woman,
right,
and glowing that picture up, uh-huh, then there's a wolf. There's always a wolf in, yeah, the pack of men. Uh-huh. And that wolf, that goes ahead like, he gets that scent. And then, like I say, I'll have to bury somebody.
So he doesn't. So you're saying, he does not discuss those inner things about her with his boys because of he protects in a sense.
But yeah, he's protecting what's his, mm-hmm, where he is, and so he's so.
I still think that's shallow, though.
Maybe, but that's me.
Why? You and your friends. So I said it's very interesting when you discuss what you shallow. And your friends talk about.
I have
not men. It's you and your friends.
Yeah, I've had in the past,
which happen to be men, so that would make us men.
Yeah, I've had in the past describe a young lady to my best friend. Says there's something wonderful about her. I didn't describe. Yes, at the beginning I described her physical parts, but after we got through being men, okay, boys. Then I began to talk about her brain and how she, her presence in the room with me.
We'll do does that things.
Yeah, we but we do that with men who we trust.
Mm-hmm.
These are our boys who we know that they will go to they will jump off a cliff, you know, with us. Okay, what's that movie with the two girls, the heel hands and whatever? Yeah, that's okay. That's who we'll do that with. But with the boys, we're trying to please at the bar,
there
at the club.
There you go.
There we get into our lustful talk.
And we're the same way.
Yeah,
you have your tight knit,
mm-hmm,
and then you have your clique.
Yeah,
and then if someone in that clique was going, because like I said, as we were all in Bennigan's, we had one friend that we would be very leery about making an order because he's like, I'm going to the bathroom. And we never see him again because he'd see a girl and he's gone.
That's it.
We understood that. Okay, that's how he is.
Right.
But then we had another one that was always there. But he would get mad over some what we would call girlish type stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Since we got the new guy right here. Let's say I brought him into the fold.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but for some reason, you and I have had a falling out. Mm-hmm. But you two keep hanging. So now I'm mad at you.
Mm-hmm.
For being friends with him after we didn't, you know, had a falling out. And he's like, man, but that's not right. See, because this, that, and other, blah, blah, blah. And then we just go and tell him, like, you sound like a little teenage high school girl cheerleader. What's wrong with you? Yeah. Well, that's not nearly as neat as we said it.
Uh-huh.
This is Christian radio.
You agree with that, Andy?
Yeah, it's like, because I think we're different. You know, like men, women, we different. There's certain things.
We're just different.
Yeah, there's certain, it may not necessarily make sense to the other, but there's things that we do. There's things like, I know for a fact I could not tell certain friends certain things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And especially in the initial meeting of a woman, there's certain things I can't tell them, mm-hmm, because unfortunately some guys do prey on those things, especially if you haven't got it sewn up yet.
Yeah.
When it's new and you still kind of courting her, you still trying to get to know her, and you there's things that you genuinely like. If they see it too, depending on who you keep around, oh, they might just come in and say like, oh, well, I might be able to pull her from you. And since it's fair game, and it's like, oh man, she chose, she picked who she want to pick.
Sure.
You can't, you know, put a lasso around or anything like that. Guys get really defensive about that. They may not say it, but they are very protective totally over things like that.
Say, there's an old totally saying. There's an old saying. Trust me with your life, but not your money or your wife.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
These are interesting friends. These people are entertaining.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's not that it's not normal or common. It's just, like I said, not healthy. That's all I said.
It's not healthy. No, and I agree with that.
It can be the norm. There's a lot of things that are norm. Sex trafficking has become the norm. Homosexual is starting to become the norm. There are a lot of things that are normal now.
That's
but
true.
We talk about if it's
this,
healthy.
Well, see, no, see,
no, it is. I'm talking about
but
the numbers are growing. And
true. If
we look
it's
at...
becoming
it's
normal.
Becoming normal. Yeah. If we look at what was normal before, for a man to look at a woman as an object, that was the norm.
Right.
For years it's been that. Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it is... the norm, I've said, is not healthy.
Right.
There are a lot of things that are normal. We look to men for security for certain reasons, and it is expected. Well, he needs to be able to take care of you. He should be able to do certain things. But if you're being honest, what we are looking for in these men and what we are saying, well, we can talk about this with, but she'll be catty with that. That ain't healthy.
Right. That's a good point. And the reason why I do shows like this is because to expose not all of the wonderful excuses men use. Because many of them are not wonderful at all. They're just horrible excuses. But to try to figure out why your man do what he does, whether it's right or it's wrong, mm-hmm, here's why he do it. And if it's wrong, here's what you need to do to help him with it. Okay. Oh, now watch this. We're not gonna always be able to help him with it. Sometimes we have to just deal with it.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. And yes. See, that's one of the biggest things about one of the other biggest difference between men and women.
Yeah.
Like I told you, when I got married and I was married at 19, my grandfather said, "Well, since you done went on ahead and done this,
right. Yeah.
Boy. If you want to have a happy life, this is what you need to do." Yeah. And I was like, "Okay, granddaddy." Yep. I'm like, "I'm already." Mm-hmm. And he's like, "Women, they are." Yeah. And I paused for a second. I'm going like, "What?" And I was like, "They are what, granddaddy?" And he said, "I can't talk to you. You ain't listening." He walked away from me. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, eventually, I got it. It's like, they are how they're going to be. Mm-hmm. Don't try to change them. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Only try to understand them to a certain point to know that this is how they are.
Yeah. Okay.
And let it go. Let's see. We'll go ahead and say, "Well, it's just a woman," to which will aggravate a woman.
Sure.
When they hear us say it, but we are something that has to be worked on. We need to be fixed, and all we really do a lot of times is pretend to be fixed.
Yeah, we do.
And when she's out of when she's out of sight, okay,
right back.
Yeah, we do put on a game. We do.
Very true.
Yeah. No, we do. We do pretend. Many of us do because that's why then we wind up getting caught.
Yeah.
In our mess, and y'all catch us every time because you guys have intuition,
yeah.
which works like a charm. That's something God put in you. All right, works like a charm. If you go looking for something, you're gonna find it every time because we always got something to hide. We men, we do,
that's right.
And you're gonna always find it. And God's gonna show you exactly where to go, what serial number to put in. It happens. I'm talking about from my own personal experiences. Trust me.
That's because you're lazy.
You go. And we do. We do get lazy.
The unlazy don't get caught.
Yes. Not right away.
This is the scenario that we.
No, there's always that X factor that's going to mess you up every time.
Every time.
A lot of times, like we talked about, you know, if women, a lot of our unhealthy thinking patterns keeps you from. We preserve the ignorance. It's not that you aren't caught. We just rather stay in the lie with you as opposed to start over and try something new or be, you know, courageous and do whatever that's going on. You know, that's the scenario. It's not that you're not. It's not that we don't know. It's just that we choose to not know.
That boy, that's so, another great sign. Yes, sir.
I was going to say. So why stay in the lie?
For the same reason.
We're pretending.
I want to hear the woman answer. I want to hear the woman answer this one. Go ahead, answer that question.
Because fear is a mother. Fear is very powerful. Fear of being alone. Fear of fear of being misunderstood.
All right, newbie,
fear
get out of my
old,
seat.
Fear of not having enough when you die. I'll earn my place.
Y'all, Alvin Carter just walked in, and the whole room shuddered.
The whole room shuddered.
I just hope all my sisters out there are praying for me. We literally have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And we rarely ever invite women
men
on Monday show.
G.
Really ever. So I want you here because, number one, we vet our guests all the time. Okay, you married, right?
Happily married.
Yes. Because I know him. I know him well. And
boo.
I know every time I see y'all, y'all pathetic. All right? Now watch this. Now. Okay.
Boo, I love you, Shmoo.
Oh,
you notice when a guy does that, he in trouble.
Yeah, right? Yeah. Y'all, she's married to Ashanti Pettaway. He is the program director over there at Moody Radio, our competition.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he was. Okay, with Roy Patterson as well. Our great, great brothers in the Lord. And you've been married.
It's not competition. You're truly in a vein all on your own.
Yeah, this is
true. You are completely two different demographics.
You're right.
They can't touch your
face. We got crazy listeners.
This is, you know, tomorrow's pink perspective.
Yeah.
So, you know, maybe we would be more accommodating then.
That is true. We are more
accommodating. Bring it.
Bring it.
Just don't be hard. Don't dish what you can't take.
Yeah.
People.
Well, I want y'all to know.
Act like men today.
Tina.
Where the cigars at?
Oh! Cognac. This is a Christian show.
I'm waiting for the Christian
tequila?
Behavior. The way we've been acting is outright outlandish. I talk about 36 curves.
Just keep it on the level. Christian brothers will be fine.
Yeah. That's pretty good. You know, bring on the old granddads.
No, he too old.
He too old, that's true. Yeah. Well, I just want to blame Tina Steele for this subject today and tomorrow. We sat down at the dinner table and we're talking. And every time she spoke, I said, there's a show. So I'm blaming Tina for it. She'll be here tomorrow, and she's going to kill it again. I want to go to a break right quick. I want to open the Bible, find out there's some crazy people in the Bible that, we're going to find some of those people. All right. Amanda's going to have to help us with those people. And then, it's 4:30 in the Chicagoland area, and I want to hear something from Betty White. I want to hear something from Betty Wright.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah. She, not that one, no. She talking about no pain, no gain. Okay? Gotta go. I'll be right back. So, Walter Jones Show.
Be slaves again when the beating of your heart echoes the beating of the drums. There is a life about to start when tomorrow comes. Will you join our crusade? Who will be strong and stand with me? Beyond the barricade, is there a world you long to see?
Then join in the fight that will give you the right to be free.
Do you hear the people sing, singing the song of angry men?
Log on to urbanbroadcastmedia.com and check out the many services Urban Broadcast Media provides. Whether it's social media, video production, radio broadcasting, or audio recording, we got you covered.
Holding to my man.
shocking. Look. Carefree sugarless gum here, Trident here. Both cost the same, yet Carefree gives you 32% more gum by weight than Trident. And Carefree's taste, electrifying.
Then the electricity.
I'll think about it in Washington, A.C.
That's Washington, D.C.
Get more gum with Carefree.
Now in bubblegum, too.
More gum.
Carefree sugarless gum.
Come on, you guys. The sun's already up. It's going to be a golden day.
Let's eat.
Oh, those golden crayons. Oh, those golden Grahams, crispy, crunchy Graham cereal, family breakfast treat. Oh, those golden Grahams, oh, those golden Grahams, golden honey, just a touch with Graham's golden wheat.
It's a great tasting part of a complete breakfast for the whole family.
Try those golden Grahams and have a golden day.
Yes!
Hey, this is Julie Norwood with 60 seconds of cool inspiration for your day. Dogs are said to be man's best friend. Dogs are loyal. Dogs are instinctive. Dogs can enrich your life, and dogs can teach you life lessons. Ladies, if you want to bedazzle your husband, greet him with as much enthusiasm as a dog does when his master comes home. Gentlemen, be as loyal to your wife as a dog is to his owner. That no matter how long the wait, you'll find the dog waiting. Dogs forgive. They don't keep score. And when you didn't have time to take the dog for a walk, it doesn't remember it the next time. Instead, it just lives in the moment. Oh yeah, and dogs play every day. The 16th century phrase, it's a dog's life, in this sense, appears to have positive validity. Truly, life will be a kinder place when we learn from dogs what matters most. That's 60 seconds of cool inspiration with Julie Norwood. For more inspiration, check out my webpage, julienorwood.com. God loves you, and He has an awesome plan for your life.
The following show is paid programming and does not necessarily express the views and opinions of Urban Broadcast Media and its subsidiaries.
Thank you for listening to UBM Praise.
Hi, ho, and welcome back.
Welcome back.
Ladies, what do you want to know? How bad do you want to know it? What are you willing to do to find out?
Ta-da!
Tune in to the Men's Chronicles right here at the Sir Walter Jones Show at UBM Praise.
Welcome back. Welcome back, everybody. It's a dog day afternoon right here in Brownsville, Chicago, Illinois. Yeah, yeah. And nothing but the dog in you. Bow, wow, wow. Yippee-yo. Yippee-yay. Julie Norwood. JulieNorwood.com, that is. She is my dear friend from South Dakota, Rapid City to be specific. And she just gave y'all a 60 second, that is. I'm going to play her every night this week because she does these 60 second little tidbits here about things, dealing with just stuff with Christians. And I like this one. Dog's life. I have a dog. Anybody here have a dog?
I do.
You got one?
Yeah.
You got one? Okay.
All my right. Wife hates my dog.
Yeah.
She tased my dog.
Really?
Yeah.
Your wife tased your dog.
She tased my dog.
But she said something very interesting. Julie said something. Pastor Julie, actually, is her name. She said something very interesting about the dedication of a dog to its master.
Yeah.
Okay. And that dog live a carefree life. And the dog don't remember if you took her to took a walking yesterday or not. She lives in the moment. At that moment, she lives, and she don't remember.
My dog don't go near my wife. Mm-mm. She remember that taser.
Yeah, yeah. But she only remembers it when it's brought up.
Mm-mm.
Okay.
She see her and go the other way.
Yeah, okay. All right. Well, she don't look at the taser then. She look at your wife.
Because who has a taser?
Yeah, but and I agree with her. My dog is very, again, she's very in the moment, but she's very dedicated to me, and she does whatever I actually say to do, that is. But... We're not telling you guys, we're not calling you guys
dogs
or telling you to be dogs, but what she's doing is she's bringing out the attributes of the dog, because I think many of us need to have some dog sense.
Yeah, and style.
Yeah, well, okay.
Oh, dogs are fashionable. They're well groomed.
Oh, okay. Yeah, all right.
I'm not even going with that
I'm
one.
Not, Art, how was your day, Art?
Rather interesting. Speaking of dogs. No.
Yeah. 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 So if you missed the sound bite, we're going to play it again at 5:30. And then we're going to play it after Alvin C. Carter leaves.
Okay. But if you notice, we play Betty Wright, No Pain. Now, Betty Wright, she was the lead singer of that group gospel, that whatever that group was called. But she's a Miami-based girl, R&B girl. Okay, won her fame in the 1970s with that hit, The Cleanup Woman. Right,
yeah.
Remember that. And Tonight Is the Night.
Tonight Is the Night.
Okay. Yeah, she's a pioneer, singer, songwriter, entrepreneur, on and on. But I was at my goddaughter's cotillion. I was telling y'all about. I was at the cotillion. All these young girls, they 17 years old. Okay.
Yeah.
And we all sitting around the table in that big room with their fathers and their mothers at the table and their aunties. And someone brought their pastors there. And this dumb DJ decided that, well, he forgot where he was. And he put on Betty Wright. Tonight Is the Night, You Make Me a Woman, in a room full of 16, 17-year-olds. And the fathers, you can all you heard was the plate go, all the plates went, clink! And they got up one by one and went over there to the DJs. I'm not sure if he got out of the hospital just yet, but it was the most ridiculous thing.
I heard the one
world.
Who held him got slapped a couple times, too.
Yeah, right. Yeah, there it is. Yeah, so you just got to know your venue. But let's go to scripture and see if we can make sense of some of this stuff. And most of these scriptures are out of Proverbs, by the way, yeah, as y'all might know.
Yeah, solid.
Yeah. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. 21:9. Let's start with that. And let's see if Amanda Pettaway can make sense of it. 21:9, Proverbs 21:9. And the reason why I'm using Solomon, because if anybody knew anything about women, he had, what, like 700 of them concubines?
See, that backs up what I said last week. You want to know what it takes to make a good relationship?
Get a man in a plethora.
That's right. Get the one who's, like, made all the mistakes, not the one that's been in that one long-lasting one.
You know, because I was going to reply, but I was in the car listening on the way in. Mm-hmm. When you all were making the references,
yeah.
And she was saying birds of a feather, and you was going in all the details. Believe it or not, the most womanizing man is the most detail-oriented man.
That's true. I agree with that. I agree with that.
Yeah, because he will listen to everything
you say
to know what exactly how to string you along.
Yes.
Because he's listening attentively to say what you want to hear.
The best pimps are the ones with the greatest ears.
Yeah. They have that dictionary of, is a number two.
I was watching a Cat Williams stand-up thing.
Oh, Lord.
And he was talking about his women. And he says, my house is dressed with this. I've got this kind of drink. I got this kind of perfume. He said, you know why? Because my girls, when they come over, this is what they like. That's what they like. This is what they like. I'm like, you know what? He got a point there. If only us intelligent men, us as preachers, would know
how to accommodate.
How to? You see what I'm saying? You just got to know. Thus, us in business as well, we have to know how to sell our products to a niche of people.
Well, it starts with realizing that your girl is not a dog.
Yeah. All the men was
it
quiet.
It was a business only go so far.
I wish we had video in here to see the faces of all the men.
Actually, I've been waiting for it. What took you so long?
Kibbles and bits only go so far
with
a human
female. But let me tell you.
Not that there's not a lot of validity to that.
Yeah.
There's a lot of validity to it. But,
those so-called dogs that the men calling them, they keep coming to his house. Why is that?
What'd you say? Help me understand the question.
Those dogs.
The girls. Okay, right.
Uh-huh. Okay, we're saying dogs because we're trying not to say the other word.
Right.
They keep coming.
They
keep coming by.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Why do they keep coming by? And then they'll go to you and talk about men, about this and that.
Yep.
And then they'll turn around when they get through with you, call that same guy they were talking about.
Yeah.
And go to his house.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's a couple things. One, like we talked about, fear. You're just looking for some. If you have the wrong, if you really don't believe that God's going to take care of it, then you start manipulating men to do it.
Yeah.
So I need this one to take care of plumbing, this one to take care of my bills, this one to take care of my emotional needs. You start looking for a package in many. So it's not like you're just relying on Cat. Cat is one of many.
Just like he has one of Legion.
So it's birds of a feather. Everyone's getting the arrangement they're looking for.
Yeah.
Right?
Wow.
And that's why you go back to it. But if you realize that you should wait out and not be looking for this, then you profound. Don't return the cat.
They're getting what they're looking for. I love that.
That's what they go. Because they are shopping.
They are shopping.
They're hunting.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. The nerd in me feel just compelled to go ahead and share this. That saying, birds of a feather flock together.
Oh, I knew he wasn't going to let it go.
We really
should what that really means.
Can you keep bringing it up?
No, it just goes, birds of a feather flock together, so as does too. Pig and swine. If they can have their choice, so too can I have mine. This is about be choosing who you wish to keep company with, not so much like with like, the way we have taken it and twisted it. Okay, that has been your Geek Moment, brought to you by Arthur Baptist, here at the Sir Walter Jones
Show. Wow, was that spoken word? That was spoken word.
We got to get him a
listen
segment.
Listen to the poem.
We got to give him a segment. Look at
Andre. Listen to the poem. No, they say listen to the poem now. Listen to the poem.
That's it right there. Proverbs 21:9. What did it say?
Proverbs 21:9. It is better to dwell in the corner of the housetop than with a brawling woman in a wide house.
So not, he didn't just say the corner, because corner is inside the house.
No, corner of the housetop.
So you got to go on the roof and then go in the corner.
Yeah.
instead of being in the house with a
brawling woman in a wide in a because so, no matter where you go,
yes sir,
she gonna follow
find
you.
Yeah.
So you got to go to the attic.
You gotta go to the attic.
No. Mm-hmm. Not the attic. Mm-hmm. Outside.
There's no corner, and now I'm on the roof.
Yeah, it is a corner on the roof.
I'm a carpenter. Oh, you gonna find a corner?
No, it's a corner.
Yeah, you gonna find a corner.
You talking about the crawl space?
Yeah. No.
Behind the wall.
On top.
Inside.
No, on top. On top. Top of the house, or you at the edge.
Yep, because
there is a corner. Yep. There's a 90-degree angle.
Yep, Beyonce got the song called
"I'm a Mace Fall."
What's that? Love on top. It's called Love on Top.
Well, that was positioning.
Yeah, well, because you know her, but his boys come in the house and say, "Where your husband at?" Well, she says, "My love is on top. He on the roof." Hey, go to 21:19. What that say? You're in the same chapter, 21:19.
It is better to dwell in the wilderness than with the cowardly.
Not a brother in the wilderness. Go ahead.
Yes, it is better to dwell in the wilderness than with a contentious and angry woman.
That poor guy. She running him to the woods. He walked by the
I concur.
Grandma.
Yeah, I agree.
What you got to say about it, man?
No, it's absolutely true.
It is true.
Without a shadow of a doubt.
Let me call Ashanti. What is his name again? Go to 27:15. What did that say? See what wonderful things Solomon has to say.
Yeah, he know.
He know.
All of me, yeah.
Uh-huh. 27:15.
And it was his demise and what separated him from God.
That's right.
Oh, it will.
It will. Not meant to be that way.
Yeah. Oh. She preaching?
I don't know.
We're not supposed to agree.
We're
not supposed to be on this show. Go ahead.
A continual dropping in a very rainy day and a contentious woman are like,
wow. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo.
Message.
Have y'all ever been in a slow rain?
It's annoying.
And it floods my basement every time. It rains real slow and very long.
Me too.
Yes.
Me too.
Yeah. You're South Side, ain't you?
Yep.
Uh-huh. Yeah, you see that? See, we done went in on that one. Uh-huh. It's
drip,
just
drip. Drop.
Drip.
Drip. Drip. Drip. Drop. Michael Thurston. Drop.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, go to 25:24. What do you say? Uh-huh, 25.
It is better to dwell in the corner of the housetop than with a brawling woman and a wide house. We did that already.
Yeah, he repeated himself.
Wow, quoted himself.
Yep.
Boy, didn't I tell you? Because he talked to his son, didn't I tell you?
Didn't I tell you? Let me say it
again. Boy, didn't I tell you? Yeah. Boy, will you stop?
The difference here, and I think people are really getting it mixed up with whom the type of woman that Solomon is talking about.
Oh.
He's absolutely correct. But a brawling and contentious woman is a woman who's looking for a fight. Contentious is to contend. Who continues to look for reasons to be upset or continues to look for reasons to be angry with you. That is not to say this is a woman who has a valid reason for being upset with you. If you're
continually lazy, they'll create a reason.
Yeah, you haven't. You said you're going to do something. You don't do it. You don't bring your check home. You gamble the check. Yeah, whatever it is.
That's good.
That woman is not a contentious, brawling woman. She has valid reasons for why you were going to protect her. You said you love me. You said you serve me. You said you lead our family, and you've abandoned us. You cheat on me. You don't talk to me. You're not here for me emotionally. We haven't had sex. Whatever it is, now we have a platform for a different one who's just hurting. She's not contentious. She's not brawling. She's just trying to speak into a space that is, you know, got some tension in it.
That's good. Hey, Andre, you heard of a nagging woman, right?
Of course, of course.
Okay. Now, you're newly married.
Yeah.
About a few months.
Thank you, he looked a little nervous.
Yeah, he looked a little nervous.
I'm just trying to see where it's going.
My wife's listening now. Don't give me no trouble now.
Like, okay.
Baby, he ain't call you no dog. No, dog.
No.
Not at all.
Do you think men right away use the word nag, even though she's not really nagging? They just use it just to as a defense.
I'm in between on that because there's times where I've definitely talked to a couple of boys, and then sometimes when they tell me the things that they consider nagging, I'd be like, nah, this is pretty light. This is pretty light. Then there's other times when there's some other things that I know is like, nah, she's tripping.
She's tripping. That is a nag, yeah.
Yeah, because, I mean, but nowadays you have so much stuff to contend with.
Okay.
So that's what makes it even more, like, I guess the tension as far as, like, the stakes go is higher. Now it's like there's more things for you to look at and nitpick at. You know, it's like if you're living together as well, man, there's a whole slew of things. Then if you're on social media, then there's a whole slew of things as well. So now there's a lot more stuff on the table than it was before. Then it's just you and
that's
her.
That's true. That's good stuff.
Well, I mean, if I can interject, I completely agree with him. Yeah. I think that what he's saying really is that there's a lot more venues or opportunities for you to be the same jerk.
I mean, not that we're not that.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying if you are a lustful man, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
If you are a lustful man on the bus stop, and then once you get a Mustang, you can just drive further and be more of a lustful man. If you are a lustful man and you just with your boys, and then you share it, what happened? If you are a lustful man,
Michelle.
If you are a lustful man in your house, and then now you can be on porn, but now you have a further outlet. It's not just on TV now; it's on your computer. You now are expanding how you feel on social media with some Instagram. You're able to explore more of what you are.
Well, I guess in the same token, then it would also be you still have on the women aspect. Then it might give them the same type of avenue to be just as petty.
Oh, absolutely.
Boy.
That boy right there. That's right. That's Monday night.
Right. That's Monday.
We don't play on Monday night.
Little Minnie Mayweather. Come on with it. Come on with it.
That's right.
Minnie Mayweather.
That's right, Ma. You got to hold your ground.
What's hilarious is that we are in agreement. You guys are like, you're having an argument with someone who's
That's hilarious.
That's the point.
That's the whole point of the game.
This is a man thing.
That's how men do. We could be agreeing, but just keep it going just because.
But then you wonder where this contention comes from. Why is she nagging? Because we're actually, I love you. We agree. I know, but you can't agree with me that way.
That's not how we do it. That was an extraordinary example of one, three, four, me.
We encouraging the young man.
We are affirming him.
Yeah, we have given him information.
Why didn't you affirm me? You get affirmed tomorrow.
Have
we said, that was good, young man. You'd have been like,
you can affirm tomorrow. It is very good.
Okay, but because we said that was good a different way.
Yeah, you said get a sicker Mayweather.
No, we didn't say sicker. Yes, we said, boy.
Play it back.
That was Mayweather.
Play it back.
You play it back. I don't care because I'm consistent if I'm not controversial.
We don't have instant replay on the show.
But one now, you understand, all we did was confirm
social media. All these things are greater avenues for you to be who you are.
Yeah, that's pretty much what it is. Just like they said, money only makes you more.
Don't let them take your testosterone.
Don't let them take your testosterone, man. It's only a test you're going through.
Right.
Hey, you're not on your own.
Well, we got Michelle Thomas and Tina Steele.
What's up, Michelle?
They all are saying, Amanda.
Can you imagine all of them in the room at one time?
I can't do it.
Can you imagine all of these guys? Oh, wait a minute. We do have all these guys.
We can't do it. Hey, go to Proverbs 25 and 24. Hey, I want to say something to you men out there who got ladies who always keep coming over to the house.
You keep telling me to read the same thing.
25 and 16. Yeah, okay, now watch this. Now, one of my pet peeves when I was dating is I did not want to see her every day. I ain't want to see every day.
Oh, yeah.
So just getting on my nerves, okay? I need some space.
Yeah.
Because I felt like, okay, if I get married to you and I'm going to need that space, you're not going to give it to me. So give it to me now so we can practice.
Let me miss you, baby.
Okay, let me miss you, all right? So you're always at my house, okay? I need you just, you know, come over Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, maybe, all right? Okay, because what happens is you will start vomiting. Men will vomit.
Where are you going with this? Vomit?
No.
Yeah, literally? We vomit. We'll vomit. Uh-huh. Okay, the Bible says we'll vomit.
And go right back to it.
Yeah, yeah, and we go back to our vomit. That's right. We'll return to it. Go to Alvin C. Preacher, boy. So go to 25. Go to 15 and 16.
I'm shaking my head because you just opening up all the rules. Come on. Man, you're breaking them.
I know.
That's why you ain't mad no more. You ain't got to deal with this. Nah,
and that's
my wife going to be walking around with a spittoon. Like the little C-shaped kidney cup.
Yes, sir. The kidney cup.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
25. Go start at 15 and then read 16.
By long forbearing is a prince persuaded.
Right.
And a soft tongue breaketh the bone.
The soft tongue breaks the bone. Come on,
that's
now.
Good
that's good
yes,
stuff.
It does. On.
Yes, sir. Soft tongue will break that bone. Yes.
Has thou found honey?
Now, okay, now has thou found what?
Honey.
Okay, now you find some honey. Read it straight out.
I am. Eat so much as is sufficient for thee.
Okay, we're eating a lot of honey. All right, I'm seeing you every day. Okay, I'm getting drunk in your honey. Like that album cover of the Ohio Players.
Yeah.
Okay,
they always.
Yeah, she died.
Okay, all that honey. That's just all right. And then what happened?
Lest thou be filled therewith and vomit.
Vomit. It. But then what is it?
Withdraw thy foot from thy neighbor's house.
Get out of my house.
Lest he be weary of thee.
I can't stand you after that.
And so hate thee.
Yeah, I can't stand you.
Yeah, you wore out your welcome.
Yeah,
now,
overconsumption of honey, you vomit because your body can't digest
it.
Because it's so thick.
Yeah.
Now, the amazing thing about honey is it's the one food.
Yeah.
It's the one food we eat that will never spoil.
Right, into something.
And it's waste.
Yeah, yeah.
It's extremely medicinal.
And bees are attracted to it.
It heals
but no,
they
make
because
it.
They make it.
It's their waste.
That's what I'm saying. Bees are attracted to it because they make it, and then you get these bears who come up to your house.
Oh, no.
Hey, boo-boo.
Hey, boo-boo.
Hey, boo-boo boy.
What's in your treehouse?
I'm smarter than the average bear.
Let me go to break.
Yeah, there's some honey in there in the picnic basket.
Yeah. I want to hear some Gladys Knight. She did something with the Pips. From the movie Claudine.
Oh, Lord.
It's called Make Your Happy Home. Oh, Lord. Starring James Earl Jones and Diane Carroll. Scored by, Curtis Mayfield, 1974. Yeah. Come on, y'all. Listen to this song. Gladys Knight, one of my favorite singers of all time.
Yes,
we're going to do a show with her.
Yes.
We got to do a show about the effects of Gladys Knight and how you're really supposed to write love songs. Make Your Happy Home. So, I'm doing the show.
Broadcasting all over the world at urbanbroadcastmedia.com. Delivering love and inspiration
24/7.
This is UBM Praise.
Mr. Green?
Yeah.
You need any help?
Mm-mm.
I just want you to know, I think you're the best ever.
Yeah, sure.
Want my Coke? It's okay, you can have it.
No.
Really, you can have it.
Okay.
A Coke and a smile makes me feel good. Makes me feel nice.
Be around.
That's the way it should be. I like to see.
Hey, kid.
The whole world is smiling with me.
Coca-Cola
has life. Have a
Coke and
thanks, Mean Joe.
Smile.
You're just smiling this morning. All of your love is wishing you well. Your tears, they just swell. So make yours a happy home.
Happy home. Make yours a happy home.
Side. I got a happy cry. All
show is paid programming and does not necessarily express the views and opinions of Urban Broadcast Media and its subsidiaries.
Thank you for listening to UBM Praise.
What are you willing to do to find out? Tune in to The Alvin C. Carter Show. It's coming to UBM something one day.
I just don't like the sound of that. Alvin Carter and BM, no, thank you.
No, no. I'm not. I can't. I can't do it with him. Yeah. Make yours a happy home. This is definitely a topic that a lot of men, as you can hear, very passionate about. But I want to go to 15 things men find annoying in women, and I want you guys and the young lady in the room to kind of tear this apart and see if we can make sense of this in this half of the show here. After listening, and this is from an article by Erica Borba, okay? After listening to some of my friends complaining and murmuring on Facebook walls, I decided to dive deeper into the subject and scour the internet for complaints about women posted by men. Now, my dear friends, prepare yourself, because the worst is yet to come. As you read, treat the exposed information as counsel on how to be better, not as demeaning. Ask yourself, would you put up with yourself if you were your own husband or your own fiance or boyfriend? Mm-hmm. So take the deep breath and read about 15 things that make men want to disappear, along with what the woman says to do. All right? Y'all ready for this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Y'all ready for this? Number one, the troublemakers. Most readers will agree with this one. A man gets easily annoyed when a woman cannot let go of the things she does not like. Men do not like a woman who tries to solve problems by arguing about it in front of everyone. Comments?
Ooh, messy. Yeah. Messy.
Messy. Uh-huh. Yeah. Comments?
That's all about attention.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, uh-huh. I was going to say, yeah, nobody, like, the one thing I do kind of generally dislike is when women download stuff, you know, like they keep it and store it, and then they wait till whatever time to bring it up and unload everything.
Everything.
And then we'd be like, yo, we're just talking about going to go grocery shopping.
Absolutely.
That's all we're supposed to be talking about, but you're bringing up everything from like the past 6 months.
Absolutely.
That's, 6 months, man.
Yeah.
Oh, you just been married.
That's right. Yeah, yeah. He can only go back 6 months.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's like, but having all of that stuff, because there's a time and a place for everything.
Right.
But unfortunately, when there's so much stuff and they carrying it, it's like, just settle it when it's the time. Like,
when
if you got something on your mind, let me know. Let's solve it. Let's not try to. Like one of my friends used to say, my friend's mother said, it's not about who's right, it's about what's right.
Oh,
I love that.
So, like it.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, so it's like, let's solve this instead of trying to prove our points and trying to see who can one up the other.
But that's the whole point about doing it in front of people. They want affirmation.
Right.
They want to know that they're right by being supported and confirmed in front of people. Mm-hmm. But that's not love to me.
Yeah. No, it's not.
Because when you love the person you're angry with, love covereth.
Yeah.
You'd be like, well, I'm home.
Mm-hmm.
But no one will know you upset.
That's right.
I know when I'm having a conversation when I'm getting home, because it's just a vibe.
Just
she
a vibe.
Smiles. It's
a
vibe.
That energy. Energy.
Synergies.
Yeah. Because like, she's smiling with her mouth open.
Yes.
It's not in her eyes. Yes. You see that glint, you dead.
Or smiling at everybody else, and then you look at her, she just growl.
Oh, that's true.
That used to be a serious
However,
issue.
No one. What I love about that is no one will ever know she's angry with me but me.
That's good. That's good.
You must preserve your man. You must preserve the respect you have for your man. I agree.
That's awesome. My father never embarrassed my mom. And he told us, all of my brothers, you'll never ever see me do that. Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And he never raised his voice in public with her. Ever, and even in front of us, all right? And I'm almost 50. I've never seen it. And he would, you know, they would go somewhere else and do that.
He who can control himself is better than the man who can control the city, right?
That's good. But Amanda, let me ask you this, though.
Yeah.
Dealing with this. Y'all like to talk about any and everything at the wrong time, okay? Because those of you who are married, all right, you're in bed. You're ministering to each other in bed, all right?
Yeah.
Sex is good.
It is
it's
holy,
great.
It's worship.
It is holy. It is God's worshipful. Idea. It is a bed is undefiled.
Regularly.
Hallelujah. I'm speaking in tongues already, but I'm watch this. Yeah, okay. Yeah. But then what happens is, right as he's getting ready to discover America, okay?
well phrased.
Yeah, uh-huh. Y'all said, babe, we need to talk.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Now he thought he was looking for India, but now he finds
South America.
South America.
He found South the Bronx.
Yeah. And so why do y'all feel that you have to do that at that time?
Well, you know, this does go back a lot of ways to the controlling, manipulative aspects of women.
Okay.
And we, if you are not, there's a way that God has clearly instructed how we are to be. Man submits to Christ, wife submits to the man, right? Okay. If you feel you have to control scenarios or control your man or control the output or control results, meaning that you don't submit to God's order of how this is going to work out.
I see.
So you need to get results your own way. Then you result to troublemaking, you result to using your sex or feminine wiles and timing it in a certain way so you can get the result you want. With bribery or with manipulation. So, wow. Yeah.
That's good stuff. Number two, the drama queen. The dramatic woman loves to create a storm in a glass of water. crying helps make them seem more convincing.
Yeah.
The quote here is, that outfit is awful. I'm not going anymore. You can go by yourself. It's like, and then she gets to crying on and on. Mm-hmm. Okay, now we mentioned the whole tears on my show. Okay, that's one of my biggest pet peeves.
Tears.
Mm-hmm. You guys use tears to manipulate and to control and as a weapon.
That's right.
Knowing that men don't know what to do with it.
Yeah.
And you guys use it a lot. I think that's an abomination.
Here.
That's right. Okay.
Now, and then.
Yeah. So, I've never seen you cry, but are you? I'm going there. Have you used it to manipulate and be honest?
No, you've never done it. I've not used that to manipulate people. Okay. But I mean, I definitely have seen that take place.
Sure.
Y'all don't do well with emotions. Y'all like, look, let's just speak straight. Now, look, this is the truth of the matter. When it comes to, sometimes women are crying because they literally just do not feel understood.
Gotcha.
Not that you got to agree,
mm-hmm.
just you don't understand.
Right.
And so that brings it, once you, and it's just like you all, sometimes I've seen men cry when they're angry.
Yeah.
They're not sad.
Yeah.
They're not crying because they hurt. They're crying because they're pissed and they don't have an outlet. They can't express why they're feeling this much frustration. So tears come down and it looks like weakness, but it's not. It's, I'm trying to control myself to keep from killing you.
Yeah.
But the same thing happens with women. A lot of us do cry because we feel that you don't understand what's happening. You don't have to agree with me. I just need you to say, oh, babe, I get it. Because you paid attention and you care enough to just even understand it.
Absolutely.
But there are definitely a whole host of women who know that y'all don't handle sitting through up and down roller coaster foolishness, and they will use tears to manipulate.
Yeah, I agree. Number three, jealous. The jealous. Among the worst complaints are against those women who are almost neurotically untrusting.
Yes, my brother.
Who's that woman in front of
us?
Yes. She's looked in the rear mirror twice now and on and on.
I told you, I had that incident going to the former wife's job function.
Mm-hmm.
And I got questioned that night at like 3:00 in the morning when she thought I was good and sleep. And it was like, well, who was so-and-so? But she never understood how I worked at that point.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm asleep, you will get the truth, but don't ask me the same thing 2 or 3 times because then you start the brain working and then I wake up. Mm-hmm. But I don't jump up or I'll even open my eyes.
Mm-hmm.
I will lay there very still.
Mm-hmm.
And after I realized I'd answered the same question 3 times, then I was like, wow. Didn't wait for a second. I wait. And here it comes again. I'm like, I don't know. I met her at your job function just like you did. You tell me who she is.
Mm.
And then it was, well, she was awfully friendly. She's smiling because I look good in a tux.
Yeah. No, I've come. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, you do look.
You late on that one. Man.
Yeah. My thing is,
she looked like...
Right. I've walked in, and this has happened a couple times. I was in a room full of people. All right, I'm with my woman, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Full of people. But for some reason, once I get through working the room, we get in the car on our way back home or wherever we're going. Who was that woman? I'm like, there was at least 75 women in that room that I talked to personally. But no, that woman that had the yellow on. okay, what do you mean, who was she? Well, you talk with her maybe a minute longer than you did the rest of them.
Been there, done that.
But you know what, man? On a whole, on a whole though, usually when your woman asks you, who was that woman? You know which one it was. You know which one it was because you see when when you cross.
No. Y'all don't play keyboard, John.
No. Y'all don't play keyboard.
Well, see, when, no. Well, see, in my former
life.
Profession. Yeah, it was former life too. Trying to be an artist, you always have those who gravitate toward the talent.
Right.
And, no, that's not.
But when you had that one walk up to you, walk past you, like, and you know, you get a bell going, like, this is going to be one tonight.
It's going to be.
Boy, I don't know what you're talking about. Make yourself plain and clear.
Right.
If you can't recognize that woman, just tell her it's you, my dear.
No. See, see, I was married to a light-skinned woman.
It's one of the many moments of the Super Bowl.
Small waist, the whole, you know, that. And anything that walked up to me that was brown skin, that was not put together the way she was, that was going to be an issue that night.
Brown skin. Ooh, that's a nice song right there.
Back to Walter's point, honestly, I've experienced that before. And you don't know who that woman is a lot of times. And I said you're not a keyboard player because it is a proven fact that certain women are attracted to certain particular musical instruments. It's true.
He's good with his hands. He has dexterity.
Dexterity. Yes.
And independence.
And independence.
He can multitask. All right. Now, let's get back. So, and because of that, especially being a church organist or keyboard player.
Boy, he know God, too.
That's good, yeah, buddy.
You Chinese.
Yeah. He know God, too.
He know God.
He know God, too.
He play on that organ whole hour.
A whole hour.
Thank you for listening to the Sir Walter Jones Show. We are off the air.
They become a blur. So when they, so we don't know a lot of times. At least I can speak. I don't know. I didn't know.
I don't know. And I was going to say, I can honestly say, I know every time my girlfriend or my wife says, she be like,
my man.
So she like, who
I
is
love
she?
Him. He was like a breath of fresh air.
He is.
No, like, I mean, he could be, well, he's 6 months married.
It's like, but we've been together for 10 years, though.
I'm about to say, it's a difference. The most wisdom so far.
There's a difference, bro.
But like I was going to say.
This time next year, we'll talk.
All right. So, but like I can honestly say, because I'm also an artist, and I could every time when the only time that my wife came to the shows, each time she picked them out, she picked them out before.
Okay,
I could.
That's a different case.
Mm-hmm. So,
because she knows you, she knows your type.
No,
you're right.
No,
he's right. There's a couple ways it can go. Either the woman knows what you like.
Or they know
because
who's
she is
you.
What you like, or she's right. seen what that's she knows point. What you like about women because you've right. expressed that with her.
Right.
Or she knows women well enough because we know each other. We know who's looking at you. So we know who decided to prowl on you before you saw her coming.
Exactly.
So when she said, who was that? How did that work
That's
out? She wasn't in the room. She was in that conversation. Right.
That's
she wasn't good. In the conversation. And she knew, well, I saw this. This girl's not to be trusted.
Yeah,
so it's either you because she knows you're weak in the area, or it's this woman because she knows she's trifling, or it literally is a deficiency in herself. She just has to deal with some issues that she has.
I've experienced this before where a conversation was overheard.
Yeah.
And a woman said something to another woman in the presence of a friend of my wife's.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And my wife says, do you know such and such and such? I said, yeah. I got my eye on her, just so you know. I said, why? What's going on? Don't worry about it. I said, oh, the don't worry about it means.
So, I know more than
don't
you know.
Worry
trust
about
me.
It, but
that
you
means
worry
don't
about
eat.
You.
No, no, no. I need to watch for her safety.
Stay away from me. Don't you come over
here. Yeah. Right. Don't call. No. I don't have a phone.
Right. I don't have a phone. Right, right. There are no cell phones in the world.
That's right. You have one in your hand.
Right,
I got one.
Right, right.
No, this is not a phone.
This is a phone. This is a TV remote. You remember like on a house party?
Right. Number four, the yellers. You have no clue how annoyed a man gets with shouting, you don't ever listen to me. You would much rather talk to your friends, and on and on and on and on, okay?
Yes.
But I agree, but do y'all prefer the silent one who's like, okay.
Oh, that's yeah.
Isn't that worse? Isn't that the worst?
Which I don't was, know which one is
which
worse.
They both
they're both annoying.
Who shuts
annoying.
Down, the one who
they're both
talking.
Annoying.
But I prefer the quiet
talker.
Sister
can shut down all
really
she
want
to. She'll find out I'm happy, I'm content, and
you're
I'm
not.
Watching Cartoon Network.
No, you're not.
But I do know. I do.
Oh,
I
yeah,
have
I
realized
you're
that
talking
there
to a twice divorced man. So
yeah,
yeah.
There are
yes,
some.
I am.
There
that
are
would prove that you were not happy.
Right, right.
You divorced.
Right.
Because the scenario didn't work and you left. The scenario that was his.
No, you still ain't learned after 3 marriages. Don't argue with a woman.
But this is what I'm talking about. Women will tell you. Once again, a man is telling you how they are and who is telling you that you're wrong.
Yeah.
This is a cancer patient telling me I know all about cancer because I've been sick twice. Well, we're talking about how to have healthy relationships.
Wow. Yeah.
So all right, we got to defend him now.
You are incredible on what not to do.
Okay,
no.
Since
you are credible on what not to do. We are talking about what to do.
Sometimes to get you through life, in order to know what to do, you need to know what not to do.
Sometimes, you're correct.
No, there's a lot of times in life you need to know what not to do. So in that instant,
many people know what not to do, it does not mean they know what to do.
But you are not qualified to tell me if I was or was not happy. What I was not happy with was an extremely jealous woman. What I was not happy with was two extremely jealous women who would go through all different types of things. So in that instance, if a woman's going to shut down and shut up, I'm happy.
Again, in that instance, what you said, what I was not happy with, you are taking the best of the two evils. Again, we're talking about what is the best.
Oxymoronic.
He's correct. It is oxymoronic.
Yeah.
But it's not necessarily an evil because while she shut down,
From the foolishness, which makes sense. I would rather have peace from the foolishness. We're talking about just how to have a great relationship, not how to have the better of the worst.
Sometimes she needs to shut down. Mm-hmm. And reevaluate where it is that she's coming from. When she shuts down into that particular state, that means emotions have been shut off. When the emotions have been shut off, then you can appeal to a certain rational side. She may not hear it at that particular moment, but you have planted the seed.
Warning, Will Robinson. Time, warning.
So at some point in time, Will Robinson, that will go ahead and manifest itself. Now, really? That is a proven experiment on my part.
Okay, number five.
In the first or second marriage. Go ahead.
Moving right along.
The present.
Moving right along. Tina says, sometimes a woman know her man and other women.
Yeah.
Okay. Number five, the fault finder. She is the type of woman that finds faults in everything.
Yeah,
nothing.
Right.
Nothing is the way she wants it. So she says it would have been better had you done it my way.
The worst.
Yeah. Those are different.
Oh, those are the ones I told you so.
Yeah. And you have to be careful if you're dating that person right now, courting that person.
Run.
Because that will not change. No, that's going to take God and some therapy and some medicine. Number six. The bad humored. Are generally straight-faced and smile very little. She'll say, who you laughing at?
Your face.
That's right.
You got that ugly little something face.
I love how you have a song for everything.
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And the women musicians.
Oh, God, yes. And writers.
Yeah, yes, we are. Number seven, the Madonnas.
Prima donnas, yeah.
Okay, these women do not like the fact that men have freedom of choice. They believe that men do not know how to use their their agency well, or even that they do not possess the maturity to do so. Generally, they act as if they were his mother. So her quote would be, you are no longer allowed to use that shirt. It is horrific. Them prima donnas.
Yeah.
Actually, I know a young lady married a much younger guy, and eventually she became his mother.
Yeah.
And it was like, we was listening to him call on the phone, and she's like, well, I'm going over to so-and-so to get a haircut and blah, blah, blah. No, you need to go.
Yeah. I dated a woman that was always telling me what to do, and what it was doing was breaking down my manhood.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes, Lord. Oh,
and,
Jesus.
Yeah, it was breaking it down, and she would do it in my face, and then she would do it in public, which was much worse. So the people looking at me like, and you still dating this chick? And I'm like, well, she don't tell me what to do. So you put on that man mantra thing. Please. Right. She can say what she wants to, but at home, I'm the man, on and on and on.
Right.
No, good world, I get at home as well.
When Devo leaves.
Yeah.
I'll be talking again.
Yeah.
Yeah, at home when nobody's around, when nobody see it.
Now I'm the man.
I'm the man.
I'm married to Debo.
Yeah, so you got right, Debo. Give me that bike.
Be talking again.
Right. Number eight, the insecure. These women do not think they are worthy of their companions. They always question themselves about their feelings and the man's taste in women. She'll say, you think that she's prettier than me, don't you? Oh, I bet if she looked this way, you would totally go after her and leave me behind.
Yes.
The insecure is one of the worst.
So ugly.
Low self-esteem is like, why? And who are you?
And actually, that low self-esteem and jealousy go hand in hand.
Yes.
Something that's not even appealing to you. Mm-hmm. And then, because everyone else in the room is staring at her, you must be staring at her too.
Yeah.
I had a friend who had to deal with that. Actually, he still deals with
that. How many friends you got?
He got a lot of friends.
Well, over 30-some-odd years, you get to know people.
Yeah.
You know they say all these friends.
Well, actually, I never said it was a different friend.
Okay. She's psycho. Number nine. The undecisive. Yeah.
He's scared to leave.
That's right. Yeah, that's Jezebel and her husband. Yeah.
And Ahab. Oh, yeah. No, Ahab and
And her husband. That's exactly what that is.
I'm going to pray for you.
The indecisive single boys have a lot to say about this attitude. They show interest in a girl and she shows interest back, but she soon acts distant. Boys feel very confused with this type of attitude. Those men that are no longer single also have their own two cents to put in it. Not being able to pick which clothes to wear, which place to go, and other similar decisions leaves men impatient and irritated.
How I look in this.
So the quote is, I don't know. What do you think? She's indecisive. Okay, so what are we eating tonight?
Man.
I like chicken. Okay, we're going to Popeyes. Well, I don't like Popeyes. Okay, well, we're going to KFC. Well, I don't like KFC. Well, we're going to Chicken Hut. I don't like Chicken Hut. But you like chicken.
What
chicken?
I'm going to the refrigerator. I'm going to get the chicken. I'm going to cook it. You won't eat it.
I don't like your
I don't like my stove. Can you buy me another stove?
Don't cook it in grease.
Don't cook it
in
grease. Right. Yeah. Number 10, subjective. These are the women with the inability to be direct or state what they want. They think that men have a crystal ball attached to their brains.
So, yeah.
Not only do they hope that the man will guess what they are thinking, they hope that he deciphers the woman's code, which is given through looks, small gestures, a nose scratch, or any other similar sign. You just don't understand me. And Alan just said when his wife looks at him at the party, it's a certain look that she gives him that lets him know.
No, it's a vibe.
Mm-hmm.
It's an energy.
Whole thing, her aura.
Yeah.
She's already.
No.
I can feel it if she ain't here.
The phone will vibrate.
And we've all seen
that.
That's messed up. We've seen it happen. Alvin make a comment like, your wife gonna. Then the phone start vibrating.
I'm gonna give a quick one right before the break. Number 11, the overly attached.
You just talked about her.
Overly attached. Emotionally dependent women are a burden to men. They do not understand that men need to breathe, have some personal time, and demonstrate total dependence on their love. These kinds of women are similar to gum on a shoe, that is. You haven't even left yet, and I already miss you. Without you, I would die. And on and on and on and on.
Call leak.
Yeah. And I don't have a problem with some of that, because there are times that men and people are in love, but they just don't want to leave each other's presence.
Yeah.
Okay. But I think this is what they're talking about is the overly. Yeah. It's like, really, you got to go pee. Go pee. And don't follow me to the bathroom when I go pee. Okay.
What key am I peeing in?
Yeah, what key? In the key of pee? Yeah. Hey, I want to hear Gladys Knight one more time. Me and I was Nana, we like that child. I went to go see her in The Temptations, and I just had a fit.
Oh, yeah, that's a great show.
Oh, my God.
I saw her in Vegas. It was a wonderful time.
Yeah, she's saying this, but she's presenting this question, if I were your woman.
Ooh, that's the song right there. And I am a man.
And this is one of the most beautiful songs ever written by a woman.
Listen to the background vocals.
Oh, my God. Well, let's go there, okay? And then we'll go to Controversial Corner after that. All right? So, I was the general show.
Do you hear the people singing the song of angry men? It is the music of a people who will not be slaves again. When the beating of your heart echoes the beating of the drums,
There is a life about to start when tomorrow comes.
Log on to UrbanBroadcastMedia.com and check out the many services Urban Broadcast Media provides. Whether it's social media, video production, radio broadcasting, or audio recording, we got you covered.
If I were your woman,
if you were my woman,
and you were my man,
yeah.
She tears you down, darling, says you're nothing at all.
America's classic thrillers come to life. The Hardy Boys' Nancy Drew Mysteries. An adventure into suspense.
There's got to be a way out of here. Can you used to go with her? Forget that.
Oh, Professor, do ghosts leave footprints?
The adventures of America's favorite young detectives come to television.
Follow that ghost.
The Hardy Boys' Nancy Drew Mysteries.
Hey, this is Julie Norwood with 60 seconds of cool inspiration for your day. Dogs are said to be man's best friend. Dogs are loyal. Dogs are instinctive. Dogs can enrich your life, and dogs can teach you life lessons. Ladies, if you want to bedazzle your husband, greet him with as much enthusiasm as a dog does when his master comes home. Gentlemen, be as loyal to your wife as a dog is to his owner. That no matter how long the wait, you'll find the dog waiting. Dogs forgive. They don't keep score. And when you didn't have time to take the dog for a walk, it doesn't remember it the next time. Instead, it just lives in the moment. Oh yeah, and dogs play every day. The 16th century phrase, it's a dog's life, in this sense, appears to have positive validity. Truly, life will be a kinder place when we learn from dogs what matters most. That's 60 seconds of cool inspiration with Julie Norwood. For more inspiration, check out my webpage, julienorwood.com. God loves you, and he has an awesome plan for your life. Ta-da!
The following show is paid programming and does not necessarily express the views and opinions of Urban Broadcast Media and its subsidiaries.
Thank you for listening to UBM Praise.
Ladies, what do you want to know? How bad?
What are you willing to do to find out?
I'm gonna pray for you.
Tune in to the Men's Chronicles right here at the Sir Walter Jones Show at UBM Praise.
Meanwhile, at the Hall of Justice.
At this time, I have the honor to present to you the moral leader of our nation, a great, dedicated man, a philosopher of a nonviolent system of behavior.
Due to some violent content, parental discretion is advised.
Politics, doctrine, current events. Let's meet at the Controversy Corner on the Sir Walter Jones Show here on UBM Praise.
This is Keep It Real Carter here at the intersection of controversy and agitation. Women, y'all love aggravating men, it seems. Especially at those moments, those intimate moments. You get pushy during the time for the... Well, you know.
Y'all can't be laughing. I'm trying to stay focused.
Don't talk to me about the bills during the thrills. You got to focus. You say it's all about you, right? Okay, say we finish and we discuss it. If I walk out of the room because it gets heated... Don't follow me. Why do y'all do that? You've been heard. You're not being ignored. It's a deflator. It's a damage control. It's a diffuser. But you gotta keep repeating. So that's that inward part of your DNA that goes, that's that nag. That's that nag cell. That's that nag gene. Y'all nag sometimes even when you ain't on the... Well, okay.
Oh, no.
Yes. And this is another thing. That voice. Wine is for drinking, not hearing. Stop whining. Now, this is the worst one. If the man decides to admit that you're right, which is very, very hard to do, don't fuss after the apology. Remember, you're his wife, not his mama. And here's the worst one of all. After you've said all you have to say, and we've listened, agreed, or agreed to disagree, then you start a whole nother conversation with, you know what I mean? I hate that. I don't know what you mean. Some of y'all, well, can you read what I wrote? Some of y'all, and hold on. Here's the one. This is one right here. Women actually look at women more than men do.
That's right.
And what y'all think we focusing on, we ain't paying no attention to.
That's true.
Because what may have turned me on about you does not necessarily be what turned me on about somebody else. That's if right. I'm even in turned on mode. Because,
right.
Yeah, it's a mode. We have a mode. Because if we hungry, we ain't thinking about nothing but food.
That's right.
And if we want to play, we ain't thinking about nothing but whatever turns us on as far as fun, entertainment. And if we with you, the other big three is you. But I'm going to leave that alone because that's another show.
Yeah, man, yeah.
Now, I'm going to close with this. Women, if you feel the need to be agitating, or if you are agitated, you have a right to your feelings. Okay, nobody control that. But this is what I say to you. Enjoy it by yourself. You can enjoy your anger. Just leave me alone.
Damn.
That's my controversial topic for today.
Controversial Corner, right here, 5:30 every day on the PM from Pissed Off Carter.
I'm not.
Pissed Off Carter.
No.
You forgot that other one, Al.
Yeah. Which one?
The one to where you all have had a debate, but you're going back and forth and you stop, you back up. I'm like, okay, I'm going to give you the floor. And that's, she done said everything she had to say. She turns around and walk away.
Yeah.
Right
yeah.
at the point to when you about to go ahead and like, okay, now I'm going to present my side.
Mitchell alert.
She's gone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
No, let her talk and walk away. The argument is over.
No,
yeah.
It's
yeah.
not. It's going back to you later. When
no,
you
if she said.
Yeah, yeah. My number one pet peeve, I think this might be my number one pet peeve in women. You know, I could put up with a lot of things that women do. I get annoyed by some of it, but not to the point of annoyance where I just can't stand you, okay? Because there are things that I do that annoy my woman. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But one of the worst things, if not the worst thing a woman could do in my presence is not listen to me.
Yeah.
Oh, no, right? That's big for me, too.
That's very hard. That's very hard for me to be. Now, here's some of my scenarios. I'm walking down the street with a woman. Okay. Because I think that one thing that walking down the street does to me is clear my head. It's romantic, mm-hmm. to me. Okay, we're one in a sense. All right, we're walking down the street mm-hmm. and we could talk about any and everything. Now I'm pouring my heart out to you. All right, and I know you ain't listening because when I get through saying what I say, you say, "Look at that bird," or mm-hmm. "I wonder what my mom doing at the house," because you know we had. Or I have an appointment tomorrow for hair. Okay, I just got through just pouring giving out, you stuff you, that I yeah, just don't give to people, all right? Mm-hmm. And so the worst thing you can do to me is not listen to me. Now, a woman may not be interested in what I'm saying, but mm-hmm. she will act, at least she can act like she heard. You know how we do men? We be, right. Y'all be talking, we say, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, yes, right, baby, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. That's right, baby, that's baby. And we watching the game or something like that, mm-hmm, that's right, baby, that's right. We say that because we want you to think, at least.
Yeah.
That we're listening.
Yeah.
A lot of times you don't know. That. A lot of times you know that we're not listening, but because you'll test us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We'll
and say, that. You know, babe, you heard what I said, right? Yeah. What did I say? Well, you mentioned something about outside. I'm agreeing with you. You like, I said nothing about outside.
But if you had started lying, she'd have heard every word.
Yeah, that is true, too.
It's something about that woman. She'll know when you're lying.
Yeah, she do.
And can recall it from 20 years from now. So remember that young book.
Let me defend something we talked about earlier, which brings it to this moment.
Sure.
And it also talks about, what was it, Controversial Corner?
Yeah.
You're absolutely right. No one likes to not be listened to, because what you're saying is that, one, I'm not important, and saying is that you don't see me.
Right.
I'm trying to share myself to you, and you don't see me, right?
That's right.
And that's a horrible feeling. The difference is, we talked about at the beginning, is that women were doing 20 different things at one time. We usually heard you. It's just we are not, like men, focused when it comes to just stay here. So we heard it and said, okay, great, I processed it. Okay, I know how he feels. And then we start thinking about laundry. We were literally thinking about 10 different things at one time, and we're not showing that we heard you.
That's good.
So it's not they weren't listening. It's just they didn't do a good job at letting you know they were listening.
That's great.
Just like in the Controversy Corner, one thing that he said is, I hate when you come after me after we had an argument, and then I leave, and I heard you, but I left the room. Well, what she's saying is the same thing you said is, I don't know that you heard me.
Mm-hmm.
You know that you heard me. Mm-hmm. When you left the room in that timing, mm-hmm. it looks like you did not hear me.
That's good. That's good. No, that's great.
That's a good point. However, if it's me, I'd say, okay, I heard you. We need to cool down.
Boom.
I'm big, because communication is not what you say.
If you said it in that way, then she should be able to receive.
Communication is not what you say, but it's what you want your listener to understand.
Bingo.
But most people speak to be heard, not to listen.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. Right. And that's what sells books. Because a man could write, for instance, I'm going to give you all some secret. I'm going to give you all a secret.
Uh-oh.
All right? Every Monday we do a men's show. Okay?
Okay.
We've been doing the men's show since October 6th.
Yeah.
All right? You fast forward. We're in what? End of April?
So you got like 8-12 chapters now?
Okay. No, here's the thing. We've been repeating the chapters over and over again.
Because there's only so much we can talk about.
There's only so much. So we have repeated some of these shows, but people don't know that.
And we renamed it.
And we just renamed it. We just repackaged it. That's why a man like T.D. Jakes, someone could write books for the rest of his life, and he's saying the same thing. Saying it in a different way. And he repackaged it. We all fall into that mode, okay?
And Les Brown made an awesome comment, too. Yeah. He said most people, the reason why he was able to be a motivational speaker as long as he was, he said, because most people either are not listening or they really don't want to change.
They don't want to change, and that's right.
They want the answer, but they don't want to apply the answer to change. So you can give a whole other book to the same audience because they want the answer again. They don't want the answer.
Man, you're preaching here. Every time I go to these women's seminars.
Why go to church?
That's why they go to church.
Just because,
when I go to these women's seminars, and I'm trying to see if you went to one, but I'm on the panel with all these men in a room full of women, mm-hmm. and they ask the questions, mm-hmm. all right? They come up to the mic and they ask
the
questions, okay? And watch this. They ask these recycled questions. They invite me back next month. Guess what's going to happen? They ask the same questions. Month after month after month, all right?
You say that's 250, please, per hour.
You see what I'm saying? I will always make a decent living off of being repetitive. okay, I'm giving the same answer. You don't want to apply the answer, and you making me wealthy in a sense.
It's called consistency.
Yeah, that's what it is. It's consistency. Carol says here, says, I know I wasn't tagged on this thread. I don't know why I missed you. I could always tag her. That's my buddy right there.
She gate crashed.
Yes. Uh-huh. She said, tagged me on this, but one day, hopefully before the world ends, men will know that women, she capitalized, are essential to your call and your greatness. We were created to be different. Without women, the world would be a total chaos. And you know what? I can't disagree with it.
She's definitely right.
Yes, that's the first time I've heard a woman admit that.
Let's finish this.
I appreciate you, darling.
15 things that men find annoying. Okay, let's go down the list. 1, troublemaker. 2, the drama queen. 3, jealous. 4, yellers. 5, fault finders. 6, the bad humored. 7, the Madonnas. 8, the insecure. 9, the indecisive. Did that mention the indecisive?
No. Yeah.
Okay, the indecisive. Single boys have a lot to say about they this attitude. That. Okay, 10, the subjective, right? Mm-hmm. 11, the overly attached. Mm-hmm. And 12, the sloppy. Mm-hmm. The greatest complainers are married men. Since single women don't usually make this mistake during dating times, men like having a good-looking woman by their side. Sanchez says people need to stop worrying about the small details. What say. Okay. 13, the digger.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. I think more about the things that she can obtain by relating with a man than the type of person he is. What year was your car made again? Okay. I ain't saying she ain't no gold digger.
Yeah, that's the same pattern that no. Find out if you into football, then she'll run down every stat in the world. And once she feel like she's comfortable, she don't want to see another football ever again.
I got to be. 14, the vulgar. Women like to fish for attention at whatever cost, including being revealed in their attire. My body is beautiful, so I'll just show it. Okay, I agree with that. Put some clothes on. I mean, I'm attracted to a woman's body, but enough is enough.
But when's enough? I mean, enough it's getting pretty rash. You
it's
have
getting rash.
It's getting rash. But you have their Kim Kardashians. You have your who's your girl ball head. Thank you. Breaking the internet.
Why are you looking
somebody,
at me? You need to talk to the young guy. I got
breaking quote unquote the internet. Somebody's tuning in and watching.
Yeah, some of course.
A lot of them are women too. But a lot of them are men. So if somebody's attracted to that.
Yeah, the tricky mirage. Yeah.
Yeah, tricky mirage.
Tricky mirage.
Yeah, tricky mirage.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Alvin, grab that board. I think one of the things, I think the worst thing that a woman could do is put a cigarette in her mouth.
Oh.
Dragon ladies.
But all movies used to be, that was
exactly.
A sex
exactly.
Deal.
Wasn't that something? But and that can you imagine
that was
smell?
By design to sell the product.
That was by
no,
design.
It's just interesting that you're repulsed by it when uh-huh. It was by design. Our friend here's an advertiser. Yeah.
Oh, we could do a whole show about stuff that was attractive.
And see, I love, you know what I love? Ewell Brenner did a commercial for anti-smoking to air the day after he died.
Yeah. Yeah.
He specifically said, I'm Ewell Brenner, blah, blah, and I'm dead now because he's
ain't that something? Yeah, yeah. That is. I call them dragon ladies, and that's the nastiest look on a woman. And a woman that cuss. A woman who smokes and
a woman
who cuss.
With a foul mouth.
Nastiest thing in the
not
world.
Not even a little bit of cussing?
Nasty.
What about, I want
nasty.
A girl who feels like my boy.
Just nasty.
You know,
what nasty.
About you want a girl who feels like she's also, not your boy, but like she's your friend. Like you can do anything. You comfortable. Like you mentioned, like quote unquote, those puppy aspects where you're comfortable with the person and you feel like you don't have to pretend with her. So a little bit of cursing
that sound like a brony.
No. They're
and a brony.
It sounds like a brony.
I stretch my head.
We're not allowed to say a brony's name on. Yeah, we can't say her name. If we say that, then
look at the Facebook. You'll see the thread.
It kind of goes with that whole love and basketball, though.
Right.
You know, you're a girl who you're attracted to who's sensual, who's feminine, but you also can be cool with.
Yeah, but here's what I want to say.
No,
that's not repulsive.
That's not no. That's not
so
repulsive.
That's a different kind of repulsive.
That is because a woman walk up to me and start using 4-letter words just out of the blue like that. That's unattractive. What your point is? There are men and women who, in their time of making love, they use cuss words.
That's true.
That's different. I'm not even talking about it. And I'm not trying to say y'all should be doing it. I'm just saying that's different because y'all have an agreement.
That's right.
Y'all have an arrangement with each other. Okay. Moving right along. I mean, that's what we do on this show. I tell the truth, and you decide.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You decide. But y'all cuss in bed. Now, trust me. Y'all worship. Trust me. I haven't heard the name Jesus and God in church that much as I've. Okay, 15 is the last one. The liars.
What you trying to say? Cousin is the only way you know you've hit the
bomb. That's the only way you know.
She cussing, you done did it. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
She cussing and praying at the same time.
The liars, they do not like to do things openly and do not feel comfortable expressing the truth. They prefer to omit a fact or two to telling the truth. I don't know what you are talking about. They're just liars, okay? Mm. Yeah, liars will find themselves
burning in the lake.
It's hot.
A lying woman and a crowing hen.
A crowing hen.
Well,
we'll lead a poor old man to a sad, sad end.
Oh, yeah, you will.
Can't trust nothing she say.
Not a word.
Watch everything she do.
Every time.
She'll smoke a cigarette. Mm-hmm. But she won't do you.
You pick it.
Y'all pretty, man. All right.
All right. We need a hymn.
He touched me.
No, not that one. Please, not that one. Please.
Oh, no.
We're going to need
Jesus,
you.
Jesus, take the wheel.
Yeah, Jesus, please take the wheel.
What can you want?
Great is thy faithfulness.
That's a good one. Oof. You better do it, Alpha, because you don't, I will.
I know it's going.
Go, God, my Father.
You cheated.
There is no shadow of turning with thee. All I have needed, thy hand has provided.
Girl, you better sing that song.
Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Lord, unto me.
Where's that favorite? I love everyone. Come on now, girl. Amanda Pettaway.
Can't wait to see you guys again.
Thank you, girl. Monday, she's coming back, y'all. She is, I'm telling you, just a princess in her own right. Hey, Gospel Night, meet us there May 2nd. That's this weekend at Mount Pisgah. Andre, you be there.
Yeah, most definitely. I'll be there. It's going to be Saturday, May 2nd. On, I think the doors open at 7
or 7
o'clock?
Well, 6:30.
So definitely be there at 6:30. Also, the VIP, they having a meet and greet. So, of course, if y'all would like to meet everybody. And also, if you want tickets on the low, holler at me because I have a couple. I'm selling a few of them. I'll get you a good deal. I'm telling you, man, I pay door prices. I'm telling you.
Oh, I love it.
Definitely. Holler at me.
Holler at him.
So, yeah, definitely Mount Pisgah, the Gospel Night in Bronzeville. We got Anita Wilson. Jonathan McReynolds,
Tone Ross,
huh? Yep.
The Williams Singers,
the Junior Sensations. So,
it's gonna be a good night.
Absolutely,
$25, y'all. Just $25. That's it. You can spend that at McDonald's with you and your little kid. The kids' meal costs you about $15 nowadays. I don't know what's going on. Hey, who we playing out, man? Anita Wilson. Anita Wilson will be there. She's speechless. Unlike us. She's speechless. All right, y'all. Thank you, Andre.
Oh, man. Thank y'all for having me.
We'll see you Monday. And Tina will be here tomorrow. Tina Steele, we're talking about women in education. Women in education tomorrow. You don't want to miss it. This is the Sir Walter Jones Show.
Spreaker.com. Sir Walter Drone's radio show, where he provides you with a biblical perspective for your everyday life. Stay connected to Sir Walter Jones by visiting him online at www.sirwalterjones.com or on Facebook at www.facebook.com/The Sir Walter Jones Show. Stay tuned until next time with The Sir Walter Jones Show with Sir Walter Jones.
If you can't find any work, I'll put in a good word for you at my job, man.
You ain't got no job, man!
Yeah, one more time. Randy Watson, how about it?
I can say that you're wonderful, but it doesn't seem good enough. I can say that you're kind, that would miss the mark. I can say that you're beautiful, but to me you are so much more. How do I communicate exactly who you are? I'm trying to convey the sentiment of my heart and say I really do appreciate the way you brighten up my day.
I can't find the words to describe you.
It would take a million years.
It would take a million years to explain.
I would go down the line and name all the things that captivate my heart. But clearly I'm not aware of words that can compare. How do I communicate exactly who you are? I'm trying to convey the sentiments of my heart and say I really